Now, after formulating a draft for a common minimum program, the focus of Maharashtra now shifts to discussions on power-sharing formula. The state-level leaders who drafted the common minimum program have presented it to their respective high commands for approval. Meanwhile, Sharad Pawar is expected to meet Sonia Gandhi tomorrow in the national capital. And today is going to be the all-important meeting that the three parties will go to the governor for.
चालू है वो पूरे होने के बाद ही बारे में बता सकते हैं और मिनिमम कॉमन प्रोग्राम में एक अंडरस्टैंडिंग रिलीज होने की आवश्यकता है वो होने के बाद ही आगे का नक्शा बनेगा जब से चुनाव की कोई संभावना है ये सरकार बनेगी पांच साल चलेगी नहीं पांच साल ये सरकार चलेगी इस पर हम सब लोगों का ध्यान रहेगा
Shri Sharad Pawar ji, NCP leader, he is going to meet Srimati Sonia Gandhi ji on 17th. They will sit and discuss and how to solve this problem and resolve. They will decide. And after that only, the other actions will follow.
And Purva joins us this morning for more on this. Purva, so it's going to be an exciting weekend where two important meetings are happening. Meeting number one happens with the governor today. Meeting number two happens with Sharad Pawar and Sonia Gandhi tomorrow. On both fronts, what are you hearing? And also this fresh attack by Sena that has come in their article in Saamna, where they talk about horse trading charges yet again against the BJP. Any truth in that? Have you heard something through our sources?
Well, to answer your first question about today's meeting, a joint delegation of Sena, Congress and NCP will be meeting the governor today around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And on record, all the three party leaders have been saying that this is regarding the lack of governance in the state right now. They want to talk to the governor about the lack of governance, be it the agrarian crisis in the state and also about the unemployment related issues. So since it's a precedence rule which has been imposed, so they want to highlight these issues in the state and they want to talk to the governor about it. But it is also a sign of a show of strength. In fact, it's like giving out a message that all the three parties are together and the government formation in the state is progressing and it is in the right direction as they want to claim it. It is sort of a show of strength which also will be done today in the afternoon. Meanwhile, Sharad Pawar will be meeting Sonia Gandhi tomorrow when he flies to New Delhi for the winter session, and that is where a crucial meeting will take place between Mr. Pawar and Sonia Gandhi, where the common minimum program draft which has been drafted by the state leaders will also be discussed. In fact, all the three party chiefs, be it Uddhav Thackeray, Sharad Pawar or Sonia Gandhi, now it is up to them to accept that draft and then talk about the power sharing. Now that is something which the leaders say that they haven't yet discussed it, and it is first the common minimum program that needs to be accepted by their party chiefs and only then the power sharing formula can begin. However, Shiv Sena has been maintaining that it has to be a Shiv Sena CM, and NCP also has agreed to it that yes, it will be a Shiv Sena CM, but they haven't said fully whether it will be a 5-year full term or it will be a 2.5-year term for Shiv Sena or 2.5-year term for NCP. So that needs to be discussed, and also the key portfolios of home, revenue, finance, that has to be discussed. Meanwhile, at Saamna editorial, Sanjay Raut has once again accused BJP of horse trading. In fact, this has come in at the backdrop of Chandrakant Patil, a senior BJP leader, telling the media yesterday that they have 105 MLAs and 14 independent MLAs support. So without them being a part of the government, there won't be any government in the state. And he has been insisting that, yes, it will be a BJP government. So on that backdrop, Saamna, editorial has accused BJP of horse trading once again. And in fact, a couple of days ago, when even Nitin Gadkari said that, he gave an anecdote of how in cricket, the match is not lost until the last ball. And so anything can happen in politics. Saamna editorial has even attacked Nitin Gadkari, saying that even in cricket these days there is match fixing and horse trading which takes place, and that is exactly what is happening in politics. So strong words coming out from the Saamna editorial. And in the meanwhile, we have these crucial meetings over the weekend. Today's joint delegation meeting the governor, and tomorrow's meeting of Sonia Gandhi and Sharad Pawar.